wish you hadn't rubbed that off, because after the show, I'll go to my garage. Guy goes, you got something on your face. Oh, that's right. Kate Hudson kissed me. Oh, I'm sorry. Is it? Yeah, yeah. So it's kind of cool.
A little kiss.
Yeah, how you been? You look great.
Good, thank you. I think Poonfisher is going to be my new alias.
Yeah, you like that Poonfisher? Yeah, you like
it? That's my favorite one.
Yeah, it just sounds, it's quite innocent.
Poonfisher?
You should see the ones we can't use.
That's really good.
Someday I'll show you some of the good ones.
I'd love to see them.
Did you have a good weekend? Did you see Kurt Russell for Father's Day?
Oh, no, I didn't.
Were you home? No.
I didn't. I forgot it was Father's Day. No, he's in Vancouver. My parents live in Vancouver now.
Oh, that's right, because your brother.
My brother plays hockey.
That's right.
And so they moved up there, yeah.
Now, see, those are good parents to move.
I know, they're incredible.
You know, I like cars. My parents didn't move to the Indianapolis 500. You know what I mean?
No, Wyatt's really excellent at it. I mean, he's really, really good. Yeah. So, you know, to follow his dream.
Yeah. Is Kurt big on presents on Father's Day?
No. No, not at all.
No,
he's like, you know, on Christmas, I want underwear and socks, and that's it. I don't want anything. I don't, you know.
Really?
Yeah, he really isn't one to, you know, unless it's a new airplane, probably like you with the car.
Oh, yeah, he's got
to
be big.
Yeah, he's waiting for the airplane to be in the driveway one day.
Because your mom, obviously, Goldie Hawn, and Kurt, they seem so opposite. Like, your mom is so free-spirity, and Kurt seems like more...
Well, they're actually a lot alike as far as people, as far as personalities. Politically, they're very different.
Yeah, they are.
Like somebody laughed in the audience. So they're really different politically, and.
So liberal and conservative, would you say?
If you want to put a label, yeah. I mean, you know, my dad's kind of like, you know, we all have a right to bear arms, and you know that kind of man of the land type. Thing. And my mom's, you know,
well. She puts a flower at the end of the gun, right? Yeah.
Well, yeah. I mean, she, you know, yeah.
So, like, the perfect thing for your house would be like a broken rifle.
Sure, or a water gun.
Or a water gun. Okay. Now, your husband, Chris Robinson from the Black Crowes. Now, are you guys the same sort of politically? Are you opposite?
Yeah, we're pretty close.
Like, what do you disagree on?
No. Oh wow. What do we do? Nothing.
You don't.
We really don't disagree on much. Well, he's a little more. I'm going to get in so much trouble.
Get in trouble. This is good.
Okay. He's more. You know, he likes to put things down, whereas I like to say things are okay. But that's okay. You know, like reality TV. You know, when I was obsessed with American Idol.
Right. Okay.
And still am. But he, you know, he's a real musician, so he's got a whole thing about it.
So does he sit, like, with a can of beer?
Well, he gets into it a little bit, and then I'll see him watching, and then I'll turn around, and I'll go, and he'll go.
Like, will he come here tomorrow specifically to see Justin Guarini sing on the show?
You know what I said once? Guarini.
It's Guarini?
Guarini.
Yeah, I screw it up all the time.
It's a bad one.
Did he follow it? Did he follow the judging and the whole thing?
I did.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, okay. He just kind of sat in the background. Yeah, I was Ruben. I was a Ruben fan.
Yeah, Ruben's good.
Yeah, Ruben's great.
Now, do you watch this new one? They have the kid one now, American Idol.
No.
It's creepy.
That really creeps me out.
Yeah, it is.
Doesn't that creep? It's a little weird. I mean, you know, having a kid. I just worked with kids.
Yeah.
I worked with three kids on a movie, and it was nice because their parents were really good, but, you know, it's hard. It's
awful.
It's really horrible.
It happens to me in restaurants. I'm in a restaurant. My wife and I have dinners. Jack, let me smell.
Tomorrow.
So you have to go like this. Hey, he's very good, and he does the whole song. And you don't want to go. And then the father goes, so when can he be on?
And the kid's like,
it's
horrible. I mean, I know that when I was little, I wanted to do things like that, and my parents were really adamant about.
Yeah, I never saw you in anything until you were an adult.
No, yeah, but I always wanted to.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I think when it's in your blood, it's in your blood.
Yeah,
very, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You gotta take a break? All right, more gold. More Goldie, I'm sorry. More
right after this.
Live with Kate Hudson, star of Alex and Emma. I'm sorry I said Goldie before.
Yeah.
Does that happen a lot?
No. Except the movie I was telling you about. the movie with the three kids was Gary Marshall directed it, and he worked with my mom and my dad on Overboard, and he called me Goldie all the time.
Did he know what he was doing?
Well, yeah, he did. Well, after a while, people were like, okay, Gary, enough. And so we did a Goldie box. We put a big picture of my mom on it, so he'd remember what she looked like. And then there was a big picture of me on it. That's what I look like.
You get to a certain age, and that happens.
I went back to my hometown. I went to see a girl that I hadn't seen in 25 years, just a visitor, because I heard she was home. I go up there and I knock on the door, and it was the summer, and this girl comes in a two-piece bathing suit, and I said, oh, my God,
what?
She looks great.
Yeah.
I said, how you doing? She goes, I thought I'm here to see my mom. What? Yeah. Yeah. I'm here to see your mom. I mean, but I mean, it was the same girl that I knew.
Except
I went, know.
Uh-huh. I have to say, like, I'm in the beginning, I was kind of like, God, you know, it's so hard. Everybody says, you know, oh, you look just like your mother or whatever. It's like the greatest, you know, I mean, how could I, she's the most beautiful creature in the, on the planet.
She was ever
and I, yeah, absolutely, and I just, I'm proud to be your daughter.
Now, are you still, you were here one time, and you were like the biggest Martha Stewart freak in the world. Are you still following
am.
The show?
Yeah, you know,
gonna follow
bless
her, through
her heart, I will. I'll visit her.
Will you visit her?
I'll go and I'll ask her tips. If she wasn't a woman, I don't think this would be happening.
Oh, shut up. No, you know what it is?
Come on.
If you don't lie, if you just go, you know.
But we don't know if she's lied yet. I'm gay. You know what? I will stick with her until she's proven guilty or innocent.
So you'll still make the door look right up?
Why not? Yeah. I mean, it's not like she still doesn't do a good, you know, casserole.
I mean, what have you made? Have the thing you made from watching your show turned out exactly as hers did, or did it look?
Yes, actually, I did a rigatoni with arugula and some olives.
Yeah, and it was exactly the same as hers.
It looked pretty good.
Did Chris eat it?
He did, and you know what? I still get requests from my best girlfriend every time she comes over. She wants the Martha Stewart rigatoni salad.
Well, how about like something? You know how she makes like a machine gun out of pine cones?
No machine guns out of pine cones.
No, you have glue guns. You don't do anything
about glue. No glue guns. We have enough guns in our.
You don't have enough guns.
I was kidding.
Now tell us about Alex and Hinnom.
Alex, okay. You looked over there. You and Alex and
Hinnom.
Yeah. It's a movie about
See? Don't look over there.
Well, it's a really charming, like, sort of a character-driven romantic comedy, and directed by Rob Reiner, and Luke Wilson's in it. And it's about a writer who has writer's block, who needs to get a story done in a period of time, and has to hire a stenographer to dictate it to. And we go into the book, and I play five different characters in the actual. The book within the book within the movie.
What's this thing we're going to see here?
This, I believe, is Ylva when you first meet the Swedish character.
Okay.
And, yeah.
All right, take a look. Yeah. And you're playing all the different parts.
Yeah.
Mr. Shipley, Ylva will help you get settled in the guest cottage.
Ylva? Her name is Ylva.
It's Swedish.
That's not a real name. Who made that one up? Jacques Cartier?
It's her name, okay?
Okay, how do you spell it?
Just like it sounds.
Ylva.
No, it's Ylva.
Ylva? That's not how it sounds.
Well, that's how she spells it.
Okay, you want Ylva? It's Ylva.
Good.
Fine. Just so you know, it's not how it sounds. Who is she, anyway?
She's this au pair.
Well, here we are.
Thanks,
Ylva!
Ylva? Now that's a beautiful name. How do you spell that?
Y-L-V-A.
Ah, just like it sounds.
Cool! Alex and Hinnom opens this Friday.
Yeah.
This Friday. Kate, always a pleasure. Thank you very much. Out of Chris Warren.